Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the FL Studio series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/FL Studio. Today I'm going to show you some secret stuff you probably didn't know in FL Studio. I just realized I'm not looking at the camera. Stuff you probably didn't know in FL Studio. This will give you a wide range of sound. It's very simple to use, and you just probably never thought to use this plugin this way. So firstly, we're going to start with some sounds. I'm going to use Vintage Fire. This is our first plugin. And it's authentic analog sound for the digital world. I handcrafted these sounds and curated the sounds for trap, R&B, lo-fi, and the pop genres. So let's create a melody. Okay, so I'm making a really basic melody. Crank it up a little bit. So you can see it already has movement within the sound, and that's because we handcrafted those sounds. I handcrafted the sounds myself. Anyway, you can learn more at BusyWorksBeats.com/VintageFire about that plugin, but let's load up Fruity Delay 3. And I'm going to show you how to use this plugin in a completely different way than you're probably used to hearing it. Let's turn off the dry level. And we're going to do stuff. So let's turn down the feedback, turn down your delay time. And now we can start doing really cool stuff. So let's turn up the time modulation. This will give it a pitch bend effect. Now let's lower the bit rate. This will create like a noise. I'm going to turn up the volume a little bit more. Okay, now lower the sample rate. You're gonna get like an extra ring to the sound. And you can feel it like in the middle of your head. It's a really cool ring. Now if it's too aggressive, you can add a low pass filter here. Just kind of dull it down a little bit. You can add resonance to add more like customized tone. But keep in mind it doesn't have many frequencies to latch onto because you've lowered the bit rate and the sample rate. Now this stuff looks like it widens it with ping pong. This creates more of a phase shift. I wouldn't really touch that if I were you. And diffusion, you need time to hear that, so let me... Can't really hear it here. Also down here under feedback distortion, you can add saturation if you want to like make it feel like it's going through a tube saturator. Gonna give you more harmonic content, but again this kind of competes with the sample rate reduction and the bit rate reduction. Also, don't forget you can shape your tone, so if you want it to be balanced on more of the low frequencies, pull it to the left. If you want it balanced on more of the high frequencies, turn it to the right. This way it's like an instant high pass and low pass filter, and you can manage the tone. You can manage the higher upper harmonics. So if they're too much, you can just pull that tone down. And that's effective because let's say you use the band pass filter. You can use this as your low pass filter. You just probably never thought to use this plugin this way, but it has, like, here's without. The sound sounds decent without, it sounds good. Also, let me turn off the reverb in the plugin. Now here's with. Sounds super like from an old machine, and that's the whole goal. Now in the other video I've gone over this, but you can use Gross Beat to take it to a new level. Quick little things you could do is under your time slot, your orange area, you could change your snap to 1/4 and just right click little squares in here to chop out the volume, so that it's dipping every so often. And to blend it in, just pull your volume level down so it's not too aggressive, so that it feels more random. And it feels like it's kind of stuttering. Now you could spend more time on these and make little micro stutters. Now in this plugin, Vintage Fire, you can set your LFO destination to the pan and then turn your LFO depth up. It will create like an auto pan effect. You hear it moving left and right? This also gives a little more authentic analog clarity to your sound. A lot of analog synths have this characteristic where they can go left and right with the sound. So now it adds a different depth to the sound. There's a billion ways to do it, but that's the quick way I wanted to show you. If you want to learn more about FL Studio, go to busyworksbeats.com/FLStudio. And for a limited time, Vintage Fire is $70 off with the code 70. I'll leave the link below. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/VintageFire. Thanks for watching. It's busyworksbeats.com.